again, everybody, and it's time to have Blue Demon Exchange coming your way. I know we've been really busy with basketball as of late, and well, we should. I'm Dave Bernhard. I am the voice of the Blue Demons women's basketball team on television and DePaul All Access. And of course, who else am I going to talk to but the head coach for the DePaul Blue Demons? That's Doug Bruno. Coach, welcome back, and thanks for joining us once again, talking about Blue Demons ball.
Thanks for having me, Dave.
I got to tell you, this is one of my most exciting times and games of the year, because we get to see so many new faces take the floor to DePaul. And I know I'm not alone with that. All the DePaul fans are the same way. Your thoughts on this group that we're going to see a lot of this year?
Well, I think when you talk newcomers, you have to start with players that are already in the program for a year. I've already talked in previous segments about Nada Jean, but Kiki Rimmer from Proviso East, Hannah Purcell from the Minneapolis area, and Kayla Caudill from Vernon Hills. They're going to be sophomores. They did not get a lot of action last year, but are all talented and all, if they will work and put the time in, have a chance to really contribute.
We're going to see some players that I really feel personally, and you can tell me whether I'm right or wrong, that really feel like DePaul players based on how I have seen them in previous years. And specifically, let's get started with a player that I've seen many times hailing from the Chicago area and Lake Park High School. That's Darrione Rogers. She's electric.
Yeah, Darrione is a special player, and everybody that watches her or looks at a piece of paper, you know, she has put up great numbers. But what I really love about Darrione is her competitiveness. I really do think she's a truly competitive basketball player on both sides, and she's got great vision. Her vision is really, really exceptional. She played her entire high school career with 2 to 4 people on her. And as many points as she scored, her ability to get the ball to her open teammates was also right in line with how we play at DePaul.
You went locally for another player that a lot of folks have seen. She's played in big time games throughout her entire career. What can you tell us about what excites you about Kendall Holmes from Bennett Academy?
Well, Bennett's been one of the strongest programs in the Chicagoland area in recent years. So you keep watching Bennett, and all of a sudden you keep noticing that the one player that plays the most, that kind of never comes off the floor, was Kendall Holmes. And then you keep noticing she's one of those players that doesn't just jump off the charts at you at a first glance. Kendall is unbelievably competitive. She's a great three-point shooter also and can get to the rim. So we're very excited about Kendall and Darrione. These are two really special players.
Okay, so that's a couple of folks that are coming from the high school ranks. Now let's go to the Big Ten. And you're going to have a player coming down for the University of Wisconsin, going to make that short trip from Madison, and that's Courtney Fredrickson. What can the folks look for from Courtney?
Well, Courtney was a big-time player coming out of high school and had a really good career at Wisconsin and put up solid freshman, sophomore numbers. She wasn't able to get on the floor last season until very late in the year. So if you look at her numbers from her junior and senior year, they don't look very strong. But if you look back to her history, she's going to bring a lot to the table here. And she's a versatile 6'2 player. She can go out, she can make a three, is a very good passer, and can guard an interior player. So it does provide some more size and interior strength, and she can play with her back to the basket.
Hey, let's go to the Big Ten once again. Jorie Allen will come to DePaul from University of Indiana, or IU, I should say, Indiana University.
Jorie is one of those players that at 6'1", but she's a very versatile player, and that she can play outside facing the basket. She has her very solid intermediate game, exceptional 15 to 18 foot shooter, and a really good 3-point shooter. But she can post up and beat you up down inside as well. And another one of these players that's really, really ultra competitive. And again, that's a theme here. You know, the competitiveness in these players is really something that you can find today in today's younger athletes, but you just have to look hard.
We talked about the returners, and here we talked about the newcomers. And I feel like at DePaul women's basketball, you know, some teams that opponents may have like 8 seniors or 8 freshmen, and it's really, you know, weighted heavily one end or another. But I always feel at DePaul, there's this balance all the way through, so the program continues to sustain itself.
We've worked hard at DePaul to build a program, and you know, we haven't done it alone. I have a great staff. I've got great administrative support. But then conceptually, we think it's important that the program sustains by constantly having players in the program that can learn, are willing to pay the price to get better. Have the patience to understand it might not be overnight success, but if you're willing to work, willing to pay the price, willing to allow yourself to be coached and taught, and then get in the gym and roll up your sleeves and work, you can really have a great career here. It makes it harder for freshmen to put themselves on the floor, but many freshmen have put themselves on the floor, as we expect this year's freshmen and newcomers to do.
Doug, I can't tell you how much I appreciate you joining us here on Blue Demon Exchange. I'm excited. I'm ready to go. I have to teach myself patience, but I can tell you this conversation, our last three segments, it's been fun. Thanks a bunch, Coach.
Thanks, Dave, for all you do for DePaul Women's Hoops.
Again, that is Blue Demon Exchange, and of course, many more coming up, and we remind you, stay safe, be well, and take care, DePaul.